Hey guys, it's your girl Juice. Welcome back to my channel. So I just wanted to come, you know, make a quick video for you guys doing my just doing like a simple makeup look. I'm just gonna head out for the day, but I don't want anything too heavy, too dramatic, you know, just want to look cute, you know. Yeah, so I'm not gonna talk through. I'm just gonna do a voiceover, and well, maybe that, or I just might play you guys some music, you know. But yeah, feel free to just, you know, watch me do a small beat, you know, a little simple, tiny, mini beat. And I hope you like it. Bye. So I did already go ahead and do my eyebrows off camera because I didn't know that I was gonna be filming at first. But yeah, I just used my, which one is this? This is just the next eyebrow pencil, I guess. I think this is the brow definer or something like that. Like, I'm not really too sure. But just the little, you know, NYX or whatever. It's in dark brown, and I use it to fill in my brows. Now I'm about to use my concealer to carve them out. All right, guys. So I'm just going to be taking my Dose of Colors concealer. This is in the color dark. And I'm going to be using that to carve out my brows. Also, I'm going to be putting it on my lid pretty much as my base for my eyeshadow. All right, so I'm gonna be taking this Violet Voss Olive You Forever palette to do just a really simple neutral eye look. So I'm gonna take that medium brown shade, and I'm just going to, you know, pack it on pretty much. Today's eye look is super simple, three colors, not really even a lot of blending because they're all pretty much similar colors. So like I said, I'm going in with this medium brown color. And then in just a second, I'm gonna be going in with the darker brown color in the palette just to put in like my outer V. Give me a little bit of definition, you know. Is it definition? Depth. Give me a little bit of depth. And I'm taking it on a pretty compact brush so I can get a lot of that color because I do want it to be pretty deep in my outer V area. And then in the next clip, you'll see me going in with a, you'll see me going in with that kind of like dusty rose kind of mauve-y color. You guys, I'm really not great at describing color, so I'm sorry, but you'll see me point to it in the palette. And at first I'm going to use my finger to put it, to pat it on to my eye. It worked a little bit, but then later you'll see me going with a flat like shading brush and really pack on that color, because like I said, it's really simple, but of course I still want you to be able to see the color, you know. All right, and I'm just gonna go in with some of this Jack Black lip balm. My lips were super dry. My lips are super dry, and this definitely helps to keep them moisturized, so I love it. All right, so off camera, I'm gonna go ahead and put on these lashes. These are just some lashes that I got from a vendor of mine, nothing special. Then I'm going to go in with my Milk Hydro Grip Primer. This primer is bomb. I'm pretty sure you already know that. If you're part of the YouTube community, it's so bomb, so sticky, and it keeps my makeup on. I love it. And I'm gonna go in with my Too Faced Born This Way foundation. I believe this is in the color hazelnut, but I don't use a hazelnut anymore. I actually just went and bought spiced rum, and I love it. And I'm just going to blend, of course, you know, that's what we do around here. I'm just going to blend my foundation in, put a little bit on my lace, you know, just blend it in or whatever. Then I'm going to go in with that Dose of Colors concealer again and put in my usual places, my T-zone, my T-zone, my forehead, under my eyes, my nose, and my chin. Sometimes I usually put some above my lip, but I guess I didn't do that here. It just, you know, however the wind is blowing that day, you know, depends. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and blend that out with my sponge. I think this is the Morphe sponge, and yeah, it is. It's the Morphe sponge, and just keep blending. So I'm going to go in next with my NARS Soft Matte Concealer. This is in the color Monday. I just like to use my finger, you know, pick up a little bit, put it under my eye. As you can see, it gives me just a little bit of a highlight. It's nothing too extra. Again, simple. And I'm going to take my Beauty Blender again, and I'm going to start to blend that out. I don't know if you guys can see on camera, but it was blending out so, like, patchy and just weird. So I gave up on that in just a second, and I'm gonna take my concealer brush. I believe it's a BH Cosmetics concealer brush, and that definitely did the trick for me. So when I'm doing my under eye, I like to go back and forth between my foundation brush, you know, to kind of blur those edges, and then I go back in with my concealer brush. You know, it just gives me a really good blend. Everything looks seamless. So next I'm gonna take my Black Opal setting powder. This is in the color medium. I really like this powder because it gives me just enough highlight. I don't like the super duper highlighted look. Like, even when I'm doing, you know, even when I'm doing made up makeup, you know, like glam, I don't like that super highlighted look. But this does just enough for me against, like, my beautiful brown skin. But yeah, so, you know, just gonna set all the usual places under my eyes, my nose, my forehead, my chin. And you'll even see that I set around my nose area and mouth area, so that that's where my makeup breaks up the most during the day, you know, where I get the most oily. So I like to put my powder down and just let it sit for a second or two. And then I go in and I just completely press it in into my face. And it works. My makeup lasts all day. This in addition to using that Milk Hydro Grip Primer, bomb. So I'm going to take this cream blush. I believe it's from a brand called Wonderlust. I'm not sure. I got it in my BoxyCharm and I wanted to try it. Usually, of course, I put this on before powder, but I was bugging. I was tripping. but it's still super cute. It looks a little clownish, but that's okay, because I'm gonna take my foundation brush in the next clip and I'm gonna blend it out. And it looks so pretty. It looks so pretty. On a day where I'm doing something even more natural than this, I would definitely wear that. So then I'm gonna take my Black Radiance contour palette in Dark to Deep, and I mix both of the brown shades. You know, it gives me like a nice contour bronze look without me having to do both. It's just a nice natural look, I think. So after I do that, of course, I'm gonna take a clean buffing brush. I always do that, and just kind of blend it in, blend everything in, because there's so much makeup right there in the area. You have your foundation, you got your blush, concealer, you know, just all of that, all those powders. Just make sure everything looks seamless always. Then I'm going to take an Ace Beauty blush palette, and I'm going to take two of the pink colors, mix them together, and just set that cream blush. And look at it. It looks so good. So then I put a little bit of powder down under my eyes, because next I'm going to do my eyeshadow on my lower, on my under eye area. I'm sorry, y'all. My words are escaping me today. But I took the medium brown shade that I put in my crease. And actually, I think I took both of the brown colors that I use on my crease and my outer V. And I mixed them together and put them under my eye. Then I'm just going to take a black eyeliner pencil. And I'm going to do my waterline. You can use any pencil. Again, I'm not sure of this brand because it came in my BoxyCharm. And I just don't know it. But I'll put it down in the description box for you guys. So then I'm going to take my Benefit Gimme Brow, just the powder, and I'm going to use that to basically go over my brows. I don't tend to do my eyebrows before my foundation, but I did today, and as you can see, they started to fade a bit. So I like to go back with the powder, just give it a bit more definition, so it stand out more and it don't start to fade into my makeup. All right, so I'm gonna take the stippling brush and the 35 Fit Me powder, the color 35, and I'm just gonna set the rest of my face that I haven't set yet. Then I'm gonna take this lip liner from ColourPop. This is the color K from Karuchi's collection. You guys, after this video, the color came out of the pencil and broke, and I'm so sad because I don't even think ColourPop sells this color anymore. Like, it's been discontinued, and like, what the fuck? I love that color. But anyways, I'm gonna take this lipstick from Anastasia Beverly Hills. It's the perfect nude for me. I really wish I could remember the name right now, but of course it'll be in the description box. So I go in with that color first. Look how pretty it is. Oh, I love it. Then I'm gonna take this new kind of like nude color, or pinky nude, that I got from NYX, and I'm just gonna put that in the center, like hella. And watch how big and juicy my lips look. Oh. Again, both of the names of those lipsticks will be down below, so don't worry about that. And I wasn't gonna do this, but I'm gonna just do a little hair clip for you guys. Nothing too serious. As you can see, my hair is already pretty much quote unquote straight. Not really, but I had like blew it out with the blow dryer. So right now I'm gonna do the laziest flat ironing you've ever seen in your life. The flat iron I'm using is the Kaposi. I got it off Amazon. I'll link that down below for you guys as well. I love this flat iron. Like, it get my hair so soft and silky and just beautiful. Like, just watch, y'all, just watch. And I'm just gonna do a couple flips right at the front just to kind of curl the hair away from my face. Nothing too serious, you guys, just a little bit, you know. I wanted to include this for you guys because I'm gonna start introducing hair a lot more on my channel. Like, I know I have a couple videos dealing with hair already, but there's gonna be more because I really want you guys to get into it. Like, I have some bomb hair, you know what I'm saying? I have some bomb hair and I want to share that with you guys. So if you like it, please be sure to, you know, thumbs up my video, you guys, so that I can have some more videos like this for y'all. Just little get ready with me's and more styling videos of my hair, because I like doing them on camera, I will admit. And this color is everything for me. I was singing this whole video, y'all. Like, the music was thumping. But yeah, so just a little lazy flat iron, as you can see. But I didn't really care too much. I don't really care for perfect hair. I really don't even care for like straight hair, to be honest. That's why I put those little flips in the front. But it came out cute. Take me a little got to be glue and I'm gonna comb up so that it give me that nice flip, and voila. All right, you guys, so if you made it this far in my video, thank you so much for watching. Oh my goodness. I hope you guys enjoyed it. This light beat turned into more of just a beat, but it still looks pretty simple, really natural, you know. If you guys have any questions about the products, please feel free to leave them down below. I know I say this all the time, or I probably say this all the time, but I'm very serious. I'm really gonna try to start being more consistent with my channel. I just don't have any idea what you guys will want to see. So please feel free to leave some ideas down below, and I'll be more than happy to, you know, come on here, you know, make some videos for you guys, because
that's really how I'm feeling right now. I'm really in a good mood, really feeling good about myself, really feeling confident. And yeah, I'm ready to get back to making my videos. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you like this hair, if you like this hair, this is from my hair collection. This is actually loose curly that I have blown out and straightened. Yeah, and, you know, I feel like a pretty peacock, you know, like just real cute, real simple, but it's not too much, you know. So I hope you guys like it. If you like a tutorial or something like this as well, definitely let me know and I will give you guys a video. I'm definitely gonna start doing more hair videos on my channel, but just so you guys can see, you know, what I have to offer. And as far as my business, I don't know if you guys know, but the name of my business is Belleza Briyah. I'll probably end up doing more of like an informational video on that, as well as showing you guys some of my pieces, some of my wigs. If you like, you can follow me on Instagram at belleza.briyah. I'm also on Facebook, belleza.briyah, and also on Twitter. I don't really use Twitter that much, but I'm on there if you guys want to follow me. Maybe I will start using it. So yeah, thank you guys so much for tuning in. Really hope you like this video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.